and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Please be seated. After the sermon this evening, Father Larrabee will be offering the votive mass of the Immaculate Heart of Mary, August the 22nd, in your missal, and then we'll be making our Fatima Rosary procession for the month of August. The Word of God was precious in those days. There was no manifest vision. These are the words of the Old Testament Book of Kings. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Today's observance of the 13th of the month for Our Lady of Fatima is, of course, the apparition which didn't take place on the 13th, but only on the 19th, because the three little children were arrested and kidnapped by the Freemasonic mayor of the town, and there was great difficulty. And because of that, heaven was displeased, and showing how one thing affects another in life, why then the October miracle was less than it would have been, we were told, because of this intervention by the devil against heaven's plan. Today we offer the votive mass of the Immaculate Heart of Mary. We commemorate today's saints. They were both of them teachers, Saint Hippolytus and Saint Cassian. And I want to tell you a little bit about them, because certainly, and in many respects, Our Lady of Fatima is in every detail of this vision a teacher. And she is still honored as a teacher today by faithful Catholics who would still examine every little detail, every phrase, every color, as it were, that because this was the day, the 19th of August, when there was that beautiful kind of a multicolored display of sunlight. It looked like all leaves or little petals, flower petals of all different colors. Everything had its meaning. In life, everything indeed does have its meaning. And our Blessed Mother, because there is no manifest vision today, truly uses this last great vision, Fatima, to teach us many things. Today is a feast day of teachers, first of all. Saint Hippolytus was a great teacher of the early church. He was a theologian. He was a priest of Rome. And he had the unhappy distinction of being the first anti-pope. He set himself up against Pope St. Zephyrinus because he considered that he was the far worthier candidate to be elected rather than Zephyrinus, because Zephyrinus was a rather simple man, whereas he was a very learned theologian. But they say that in his learning, Hippolytus actually went a little bit astray himself, especially on the explanation of the great mystery of the Blessed Trinity. And in any case, when the successor to St. Zephyrinus was elected St. Callistus, why, he found him to be absolutely impossible and unbearable. And, well, they didn't have internet in those days, but he launched a series of horrible calumnies against that pope, trying his utmost to blacken his name. But the interesting thing is that this man, who had such a checkered career, a real intellectual, a great teacher, and a holy man in his own right, but then an anti-pope and a man guilty of some terrible sins against the public peace and the good name of the clergy, that eventually God gave him the grace to die as a martyr, by living in exile near the Black Sea, then to be reconciled with the church by means of another pope, St. Poncianus. And the two of them died together as martyrs, and the true pope reconciled the anti-pope or the false pope, that there should be unity in the church and that he should be forgiven. Today is the feast day of Our Lady, the Refuge of Sinners. And you see that all of the time, and it's a very consoling truth that not only are our sort of ordinary daily sins mercifully forgiven by heaven, but even the big ticket items, they too can be and will be forgiven by a merciful God, especially in our day, through His Mother. the followers of Saint Hippolytus were so devoted to him and were so vocal in their demonstration of loyalty that they did for this man, this saint and martyr, what wasn't done for anyone at that time. That is to say, they erected a statue in his honor. Because back then, nobody had statues, because that was still considered too pagan. The very most would be discreet pictures on the catacomb walls. But the followers of Hippolytus erected a great statue, and around the base of the statue were the names of all of the books that he had written, and to honor him in that sense as a very great teacher. But truly, the greatest teaching that Hippolytus passes on to us today is that regardless of your learning, you may still be able to save your soul. And regardless of your sin, you certainly will be able to save your soul if you have the humility to do penance. And he had the great grace to do penance by shedding his own blood after a very bitter time in exile for the Christian faith. And thus he was able to make reparation for some of the sins, at least, that he had caused in disturbing the peace of the early church. The other teacher whom we honor today, you might say along with Our Lady of Fatima, was such a great teacher to us, as I say, in every detail, which we love to sort of study and meditate on, don't we, as these apparitions come up each year. The other great teacher saint is Saint Cassian. Saint Cassian was a teacher, a layman and a teacher, who, arrested for the faith, refused to deny it. For his punishment, he was given over to his students, and I suppose many a student has thought of this. This would be a nice thing to do, to get revenge on a teacher, to put him to death some way or another. And that's exactly what the students of Cassian did. They put him to death one way and another. Back then, the students, of course, had not paper and pencil or pen, and certainly not computer, but they had it was called a stylus. It was a wooden board, and on it was a wax surface. And with the stylus, which was a sharp writing instrument, they were able to write their lessons out in the wax, and then with the other side of this instrument, they were able to rub it out and then start over again. Well, the sharp edge of this pen that each Roman student had was used for the instrument of martyrdom of our saint. You can imagine how painful that would have been. They literally, sometimes isn't it true that the little sufferings of life, the little inconveniences, annoyances, little words and gestures and misunderstandings and the rest of it, he's the saint, Cassian is, of suffering the little things of life, because he was pricked to death. And then some of the boys who were bolder then took the stylus, the pens, and they ripped his flesh. So that it was very much like our Lord towards the end during his scourging or his crucifixion on the cross. It was a very long and an excruciating torment that this teacher endured to be loyal to the truth of the one great teacher of us all, Jesus Christ. Remember teachers, pray for them at your Holy Mass today and ask Our Lady for the grace that everyone will put themselves at her feet as the true teacher. We still love to study Fatima and every detail and every color and every phrase. I was reading something the other day about the significance of Our Lady coming in October in Fatima, just coming for a moment and showing herself dressed in the Carmelite habit, and how that indicates, according to Sister Lucy, this would be a typical example of the studies that are done, that the wearing of the scapular is essentially connected with the message. You've got to pray the rosary and wear the scapular. Those two things. And then, as the Pope explained, the wearing of the scapular is our sign of a true dedication to the Immaculate Heart of Mary. Our Lady, most of all, is a teacher. And if she teaches us this and that fascinating truth, and things that we easily forget, what one person does affects another, Our Lady, most of all, teaches us the mercy of God. God has willed to establish devotion to my Immaculate Heart for the Hippolyti and for the Cassians, as well as for the Diocletians of our day. There is mercy to be found, and for you and for me too, in Mary's heart in the wearing of the scapular, in the meditating of the mysteries of the rosary. Let us ask Our Lady to teach us this lesson and never to despair of learning it. God bless you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.